old city of Lincoln. The face of the city has changed dramatically during the course of this century. Modern office blocks are interspersed amongst the older buildings. Lincoln today is a city of commerce and industry, bustling with activity.
Teachers up a bit.
I reckon school was a waste of time for me. Mm-hmm. It didn't get me nowhere. I clashed with the teachers, let's say. They didn't like my idea of a joke, and I didn't like their idea of authority.
I got suspended like between 20 and 30 times while I was at school, and then they gave me an extra 4 months study leave, as they called it. Fighting, smoking, general course control, that's what they mean. They just weren't right for me. I'd rather be out working, because sitting in the classroom all day, it just gets boring.
I went on a school trip to Disneyland in Paris, and that was the best thing I can remember about school.
When I was younger, I would have liked being a vet or something to do with animals, but because I was always in trouble, they always told me I'd never be anything. So I just wiped school out of my mind and couldn't care less about anything.
When I was at school, I enjoyed art, music and drama, and lessons where the teachers were nice.
I was kind of kicked out from my non-attendance. I had a few problems going on at home, like, so I didn't go much. And when I did go, I was ignored, basically. They didn't think I was worth trying to help because I wasn't doing much. So in the end, they kicked me out by expelling me. I couldn't go there and I couldn't get to another school because I was still on their books. So I didn't get to take my GCSEs, which has screwed me up for now. I actually made it into the sixth form at school, and I wish I'd gone to college straight away because I stayed in the sixth form at the school I was at, and that meant I stayed with the teachers. And as the saying goes, mud sticks. So I was asked to leave. I wasn't expelled, I was asked to leave halfway through, so I never finished it.
After school, I decided to go to college because I wanted to progress my career and have a nice background so I could get into the IT industry, because I wanted to be a computer programmer.
The atmosphere I didn't like, and the teachers and everybody, and I felt like I didn't fit in really. I wish I could have stayed at school and completed it, but not really a lot I can do about that.
I'm not what you'd call stupid, but I was stupid in the way that I didn't care about how I did. It didn't seem important to me at the time. I was young, immature, and just interested in having a laugh, really. But at the age of 11 to 16, you don't give a shit. You're not interested in what anyone's got to say. All you know is that you're right, and that's it.
I worked in a garage making wheel clamps and hitch clocks for 2 years. I was in weekends after school and summer holidays. After that, I worked in about 10 different factories. And I worked in a shop. I think that's about it.
When I left school at St. Peter's, St. Paul's, I didn't do anything after that. I just went to the farm all the time because I couldn't find jobs here. Then I thought, I'm not just sitting around waiting for a job to come to me. So I helped my granddad out.
Because I failed most of my exams, it's screwed up my chances of getting a job, really. Because most jobs now, you need GCSEs.
Since I left school, I've been to several training providers and through these I've been a groundsman at Lincoln City Football Club for a time. I've been on a regeneration project, renovating houses. I've done painting, decorating, carpentry, joinery, a bit of bricking, just basic skills in all that type of stuff.
I'm on a training scheme in Lincoln at the minute, and I went there 6 months ago. But now I've started again 6 months later, and I was told it was the last thing I could do else I'd be on my own, basically. When they said it was my last chance, it's like, because of the other training schemes, you need a few GCSEs and you need to be a bit brainier than what we are. If I don't do very well here, then I'm going to have to find a job by myself.
I'm not really sure where I'm going to go from options, but I'm mainly going to be doing my own training from home on my own computer to learn programming.
I get my £40 a week and I pay my mum and dad £10 rent. And then I just spend the rest of my money on myself or things that I need. but it usually runs out pretty quickly.
When I buy food, it's roughly, I spend £15 a fortnight at most. Just go into cheap supermarkets, pick up old cheap pastas and stuff. I haven't got a fridge, I haven't got a freezer, so anything I have has to be dried so I can just boil it up, you know, or beans, stuff like that, just tins.
I get £40 a week on my training course, and out of that I've got to pay my rent and buy my own food and clothes and any other bits and pieces that I need.
I leave most of that in the bank, just take out what I need for the week, food and dinner-wise and that, and then on Fridays, go out sometimes, I'm saving up for a car, so.
I'm trying to find money, because at Options where I work, we don't get paid very much, and if we go on a placement for work, we still get paid the same amount. So I'm most probably going to be looking in for a weekend job, factory work, things like that, because they're well-paid jobs around here.
First thing I do is get my shopping when I get paid. After that, I pay my court fines, I pay my bills, I pay my rent, I pay people I owe from what I've had to lend, and whatever I've got left is just basically have a good time on, which isn't much. What I would consider a luxury is jam, basically. I bought some jam the other week. That was a luxury. I can't usually afford to stretch to it, you know. I don't usually have milk, no dairy products, because they cost too much. I haven't got nowhere to store them. Like I said, I ain't got a fridge or anything.
I worked at a chicken farm here. The things I did is dead checking, looking for dead chickens, what was on the bottom of the cage, and some of them alive, and there's about 10 or 20 a day dead, and it was hard working.
I've done a couple of jobs like factory work and double glazing, and I've done waitressing.
I've done a lot of research into a company that I want to go work for. I've been to their website, I've researched all of the background, and quite a fan of their company anyway, that's why I want to go work for them.
I've got a dream of being a film director and writer. They try and stifle it. They say, nah, you'll never do that. You'll never go there. It takes a genius to go there. You know what I mean? They tend to stifle your dreams. This may sound silly, but the best thing that can happen to me is if I get put on probation, because they can help you, so I've heard.
There's nothing for my age group or younger, there's nothing around, nothing available for them.
Young people aren't treated very well in Lincoln because not a lot of them got jobs. So we're out on the streets all night and walking about, and it just gives young people a bad name.
My friends from school, most of them have turned to drugs. Some of them are quite high up in working in solicitors and things like that, the ones that stayed at school and did it, but the ones that left when I did, or just after, they've all turned to drugs and that.
Yeah, it's fairly easy to get drugs in Lincoln. I think it's amazingly easy.
More and more people in Lincoln are turning into criminals. Most of my mates are turning to drugs, and it's really screwed them up. They just go out nicking motorbikes and cars and shoplifting just to get more money for drugs, and that's basically all they do all day. Well, they were like the same as me. They didn't like school, so they started bunking off and then got in with the wrong crowd, and then they started taking drugs.
Thank you.
10 years' time, I want to be in a full-time job and have my own family and my own house.
Still living in Lincoln, or somewhere near to Lincoln, so I could be near to my family still.
I'd want a good job and my own house and my own car.
In 10 years' time, I'm hoping to have a decent, secure job, family maybe, nice house, just getting on with my life.
In 10 years' time, I'd like to have a family and I'm still working and my own house. I don't mind Lincoln, it's alright, but it would be a different experience living somewhere else.
Thank you.